Well, hey, Minorcan Navy, welcome back to the channel. And today we've got a video that we're going to put out, and we're going to call this Death of a Shrimp Boat. I'd like to introduce you to Miss Janette. She was born in Louisiana, and you kind of tell that she was originally designed as an inland boat because of how flat the bottom of the hull is. Originally, this boat was constructed as a skimmer boat, and it would have been used in the bayous and backwaters of Louisiana and their shipping industry there. But she made her way over to the East Coast and ended up in Georgia as a trawler. And the boat was very useful in shallow water and did its service. The owner fell ill, he died, and the boat just kind of fell into a state of disrepair until the dock kind of acquired ownership of it. And it was originally going to be planned to be an offshore reef, but after some issues developed because the owner had passed away, plan to put it in the offshore reef program was scuttled, and the responsible thing to do is to dismantle the boat. Now, this is when we originally kind of met up with the Miss Janette. You can see the nozzle is still there in where the propeller would have been area. You can tell by the marine growth that she hasn't been up for a while. This time she was put up because she had developed a leak and had to be patched. And you can see that they had already kind of started making some start on the boat by removing the outriggers and the boom. That was part of the offshore program in order for it to get in that program. All the anything that a diver could become entangled in had to be removed. Of course, the engine. Looks like they had a Cummins in it, and marine transmission in both those units were brought out, and they had moved on and were utilized in another application. So that part is good. That engine continued to live on and is helping somebody else now. The engine and the transmission were in pretty good shape, and they had more life in them, and of course they were used again. You see here, the rigging's still in place. The exhaust was still in place, and all this stuff had to be removed for the reef project. And we see the boat here now. This was part of still in preparation and anticipating its sinking off the Georgia coast as a reef. You see they've taken the nozzle off of it here, and that is a usable piece, and then the rigging had been cut off of it. Well, here a recycle trailer has shown up. A decision was made that since the reef project was a no-go, to go ahead and scrap the boat. When we take a fly around, they put the boat up on the railway. You can see the front, very front part of the wheelhouse was removed. And this thing was just cut up into manageable pieces with a large crane. That was getting the wheelhouse cut off of it. And then they systematically started working on it with the torches. Now, at this point in the operation, the fuel tanks had already been removed as well, and all that's pretty much left of this boat is the steel that comprised the hull and the structure part of it and the wheelhouse. It doesn't sound like much, but it's a lot of torch work that's required to get this thing cut up into manageable pieces. That process developed over, I guess, a period of about a week. I've been working on it. They would cut through a lot of the structural pieces of it, but leave a little bit intact until they got the crane on site and then they would finish cutting the pieces. And, you can get to see that here coming up here. This is part of that operation, going in and cutting out the areas where they had to get into kind of section this hole up. Now, there was a bit of concrete that was in the hull. It was used for ballast and for insulation purposes in the ice hole. And there's some of that that is still left. See, that's going to be another piece of the puzzle, breaking that up, getting the concrete off of it so that they can send the steel off for scrap. You can see the trailer's beginning to get a little bit of debris in it as part of that boat's making its way onto the scrap trailer. And once the crews had completed sectioning the shrimp boat up into pieces, they managed, they brought the crane in. They started to fly the sections over and put them onto the ground where they could systematically attack them. They cut them in pieces that would go into the trailer for the trip over to the scrapyard. You can see they got the bow section off. I guess you want to call that the midsection. The aft pieces, two pieces there, were still on the cradle at this point. But they've got to get in there and work on some of that concrete and get it broken up before they can load it into the container.
Ah.
Well, as you can see in this last video, they've got most of the shrimp boat put into the trailer. There's still some to be cut up. But she's quickly becoming smaller and smaller, manageable pieces. And the shrimp boat here is just about completely dead. It'll live on after it's recycled into more steel for another product. I just can't stop thinking about the days where this boat was working in the Gulf Coast of the United States and here in the southeastern part of Georgia, and what it did and the livelihood that it brought to the crew that once called this their vessel. Well, hey, that's about all the time we've got today. Thanks for watching the video. We'll ask you to leave us some comments. Give us a thumbs up. Most of all, I want you guys to be safe out there.